All right, so this is going to be my. I'm gonna try and make an in-depth tutorial on how to make flaw style thumbnails, like the flaw style. I'm gonna try to show you guys everything that I do, but some things I will not promise because sometimes like I'll just leave them private. But this is going to be me showing you guys how I make my thumbnails. So I made a really big mistake, all right? Something about my recording, like, it got fucked up. And I made this for the tutorial. And I'm gonna have to remake it right now. So I'm gonna try my hardest to remake what I just did and show you guys at the same time. Alright, so we're gonna ignore this part because I'm gonna try my hardest to remake this so I don't, like, give you guys, like, the wrong information and shit, alright? So you make your new file, the standardized, dimensions for the thumbnail. I'm gonna reuse the screenshot that I have. You can use any screenshot. I'm just taking the one that I used for Ayoyo's thumbnail, his whatever pack folder thumbnail, because I don't have any recent screenshots at all. You want to make the character pretty big in the thumbnail, no matter like how big it looks right now. It's gonna be decently small on YouTube, so you want to make it decently big. Position it in the middle if you want to. If you're not 100% sure that it's in the middle, then you want to do this real quick. Like, you want to start selecting the character first, and then you'll want to reposition it to see if it's in like the middle of the canvas. So use your polygonal lasso tool. Press Z to zoom in and out. You drag and stuff. Zoom in right here. I just press L to go back to the lasso tool. And then you start selecting your character. One tip that I would give you guys is to never go like exactly on like the pixel part of the character, because then you'll be selecting the blurriness of the character, which you don't really want. So you want to like cut some of it off so it still looks pretty high quality. If it gets to a point where you can't see the sword, just like try your hardest. And if it's like too blurry right here for you to get like the exact lines for the sword, then you can just go ahead and make a straight line. It's not gonna hurt. All right, so now you got your character. You want to still have the lasso tool selected. You want to right click in the middle of what you selected, layer via copy, and now you should have like a layer that's just the character. But I'm gonna fix this one part because that's obviously not where the sword is or where the armor is. So now, to ensure that everything's in the middle, you want to select both layers. Do that by holding down Control and selecting the other layer. Press V so you can move it around. Don't do that yet. And then you do Control A to select everything that's like in the canvas. And then up here you have these tools. You wanna center it horizontally, and that was not good. Do it horizontally and vertically. I can do Control D to deselect everything again. And then you can move the background to where the character is, just for safekeeping. Next up is the layer styles. Now, this will all depend on the size of the character, because if you put like a lot of glow and then you put it on like a smaller size character, it's gonna take over more of the body, and it just won't look good. So the way you want to adjust this is just according to like the size and just what looks good. This is the one that I used for this tutorial. You want to use inner glow, two gradient overlays, and a drop shadow. Ignore the pattern overlay. No one uses that. You can go ahead and pause the video for these settings. I got two overlays because I don't know, more color, more. Yeah, more color. Both different opacities. I don't know why, but it just works. Drop shadow, it really depends. I see that a lot of people love putting like a shit ton, but I don't want to put too much because I don't know, it just looks cleaner if you weren't to put too much. No, there's this thing that I do, right? I put like a little bit more detail onto the character itself. So what you want to do is Control J on the character layer, so it duplicates it. Clear the layer style so it's just default. Go to filter gallery and artistic plastic wrap. It looks kind of goofy right now, but if you go to like over here, you do like soft light if you want to. You can mess with the opacity. And like honestly, you can't really tell the difference if you were to put this on like a thumbnail. But if you love showing this stuff to your friends, just to like show them how good of a GFX you are, like they can probably tell like these minor details. It's really nice. Now do it again. Do the same thing. You duplicate it. Clear the layer. I say put it over this one, and then do filter gallery. You want to do neon glow. I'm looking at the other PSD. I did color, cause stuff like this, it just makes it look slightly better, like somehow. And you can just mess with it. You'll get like a different color every time, or if you want to, you can just like switch it up. And then I mess with the opacity, I erase some parts of it. Sometimes you want to duplicate it again, just to give it more color, because why not? So yeah, it looks kind of cool right now. Now, this is what I've seen on other people's thumbnails. I don't know who got the idea, but it's actually a really good idea. They duplicate the original character, like with the layer style and all. You keep it, don't like clear it or anything. You make it bigger. The background, you adjust some parts of it so it doesn't look too funky. Like something like that. And then you can do like overlay so you can get this little effect in the back. So yeah, that should be it for the character part. Pretty sure we're done with that. And next thing you want to do is do stuff with the background. So you click on your background layer, filter, blur, radial blur, like everyone's favorite effect ever. You can do a zoom if you want to, and also if your picture's like not in the center at all, you can just move this so it goes like around to where the center is. If that's not where it should be, then you can like move it again. But for this tutorial, I'm just gonna do the actual spin because that's what everyone loves to do. My recommended amount is like 7 to 8. I think 8. No, like 5 to 7. 8's too much. So we'll do 7. You got this little effect, this bad boy. And one thing I do is that I do Control J, I duplicate the background. Go to filter gallery. I think it's sketch, yeah. This crayon effect. It's sick. And right here, you want to like just mess with it, honestly. You can do some like weird type of effect. Like it'll look cool somehow. I don't know how, but it'll look cool. I'm gonna change the color actually. I think this is how you change it. I still don't know how you can. Yeah, that is how you do it. And then like color. So it kind of looks like that, which is kind of nice. Change the opacity for a little bit because you don't want to be like full on color like that. Unless you can just make it work somehow. This is all just like messing around to see like what you want to do. Now, this is one thing I really like to do to give this whole thumbnail more color is I put a gradient on it. You can put it like over the background and do a gradient. Maybe release it too. And then you can mess with the blending of it. Not quite sure what I did with this. I did exclusion or whatever. Something like that. That just gives it more color, you know? And I'm gonna need you guys to be patient with me because we are far from finished. Like with the gradient stuff, you can pick whatever color you want. and hopefully it'll look good. This is what I used for the last one. Just looks nice. Like, it looks very odd, but stuff like that, it does look good to a certain extent. Like, just these two gradients, it changes the color of everything. And it's so nice. And now I'm gonna teach you my recent style of text, to where, like, it has the text, it goes behind the person, but, like, there's, like, an outline of the text that goes on top of the person or your character. This is the font I'll be using. Yeah, you want to make it, like, somewhat bigger so everyone can really see it. It's not getting bigger like how I want it to, but do it, like, across the whole thing. And, this is one of my text styles. I'm gonna take it from here because I did tweak it a little bit. But I'll just give you guys one of my many text styles. Looks like this right now, but it does get better, I swear. There's inner glow, there's satin, I have no idea. Color overlay, gradient overlay, outer glow, drop shadow. And again, it really does depend on what the size of the text is. And you'll just always mess around with your settings. And what is next is I would duplicate it. I would do the same thing as I did with the character. You duplicate it and then you make it slightly bigger. Like that. So you have these two layers right here. Both of them are definitely going behind the character right now. But you're going to duplicate the top tutorial layer again. And then what I do is I go to blur. Actually no, I rasterize this whole thing first. So now it's like all the layers are, all the effects are in like one layer, it's smushed together. You go to blur, motion blur. It depends on how much you want to put, but I'll just put like that much, maybe? That much, yeah. And it looks really funky right now, I swear. But if you do overlay, and then you mess with like the opacity, it looks even better. See how like this little blur effect with your text. And now you can put both of these, all three of these under the character. Okay, you want to take the original text layer again, duplicate it, but you want to clear the layer style, so it's just a blank text. You put it on top of the character, create clipping mask, and do fill 0. You go into blending options, stroke, white, and make it pretty thin. Not too thin, to where they can't see it, see the text on the character, but like 3 is fine. That's what I just did. And after doing that, you want to rasterize the whole thing. So it is now just a stroke. Blending options again. You drop shadow, so you get like some shadow in the middle right there. Yeah, that should be how it looks like right now. And I have these special color corrections that I put on all of my thumbnails. They make it darker and they make it like somewhat more bright, vibrant. I'm literally just gonna take it from here. It makes a huge difference. Huge, huge difference. It's like the reason why my thumbnails are like the way they are right now. I have this one where there's like lights at the top. Subtle difference. And on the other hand, I have this light that I put. Not like that. Put it under here. And then put the light like either on the character or above it. It's kind of subtle, so you guys can't really tell. But it's definitely there, I swear. And with this these color corrections, it really makes a huge difference. Like, look at that. I sadly will not release this part because these are so precious to me, and they make a huge, huge difference. For this, you want to put like some stocks or like particles and stuff. I already have a folder dedicated to this. It literally just has like some like stars and stuff and fog. That's literally just what it is. Fog is really a game changer, dude. It really changes the texture of the thumbnail. It gets kind of subtle, but you can definitely see it. Big difference with and without it. Your next step is to save this as a PNG right now. Whatever name as a PNG, you want to open it back up. And then filter, magic bullet. I don't have like a tutorial on how to get magic bullet for free, but I did get it for free. I don't know if there's like a safe video out there right now, but I got this like quite a bit ago. And this like, this carries all of my thumbnails. You can do curves, you can do lens distortion. This little glitch effect or whatever. Like, this stuff is sick, and it really does carry the flaw style. Like, this is what I use for it. And I would say that's it. That's like me trying. I'm gonna put this like side by side to see if like it's actually similar. I really tried remaking it again. Hopefully it is somewhat similar, but that is literally how the flaw style works. This is how I make like most of my montage, like edit thumbnails. If you want a border, you definitely can do that. You do just make a new layer, fill bucket, zero fill, blending options, and you do like an inner glow. I don't do like the whole box thing. I don't like that. I just do like a kind of close to the edge glow. And then you got that part and you just Control Shift S and you save it. And that is how the flawed thumbnails are made. So because I did quit, I might as well just like let everyone know how I make my thumbnails, because that's kind of how I was, what I'm known for. I hope this really helped you guys learn how to improve them, and hopefully do not entirely copy this and try and make your own style out of it. Maybe like a few changes. But yeah, that's all from me.